Well, it's 10 o'clock on a Sunday, a day of rest. Why am I not? I don't know, because I'm out here working on bikes. So I just put the 441 aside. I've got the 72 TR6 here, high speed, and it's all set up. And I'm going to put in the new sprocket. This is all the stuff that goes in the primary case, all the little bits, and they all have to go in the right place in the right order. This is the old box. This is the box of bits, stuff I've taken off this bike. That's not going back. I can take this sprocket now and put it into the box of bits because this is the new one here. And we'll try to fit it and see how it goes, and I'll let you know in a few moments. Okay, well, there was some concern about whether or not a 20-tooth sprocket would fit into the access hole, and it does. It slides right in there. It's no problem at all. Slides home beautifully. So I hope we've laid that to rest. You can put a 20-tooth sprocket on a 5-speed. So now I'm going to start bolting everything together. All right, sprocket's in place. It's actually already tightened down, but I'll show you how I did it. I used the sprocket locker tool that I've shown you before. I'll take it out and show it to you in just a minute. It's wrapped around the sprocket in order to lock it in place. Then I took a monster 1 7/8 inch socket, put it in here, there, and snug it down. There. All right, snug it down. You don't have to torque it. It's not going anywhere. All right, so that's done. And this is the sprocket locker tool. It's an old fork leg with a section of chain bolted to the end. Just put a bolt right through it. So I use that to lock the sprocket when I'm taking it off or when I'm putting it on. A couple of nice tools. Now I'm going to bend this locking tab down to hold it there. I'll show you how I do it. Let's see if this works on video. If I can grab it. There we go. There, that's good luck. That's not going anywhere. Let's see if I can zoom in on it for you. That's a pretty good lock. I'm gonna hang the chain now. I always buy oversized chain and then cut it to length. So I'm going to move the rear wheel as far forward as I can get it and then cut the chain to length. And that gives you the maximum amount of adjustment as the chain wears. I'll start that in a second. Okay, we're fitting the chain now. I'm fitting the chain now. There's no we here today. And first and foremost, you save no time at all by not taking off the chain guard. Take the freaking chain guard off. You'll spend more time fooling with it than anything else if you don't take it off. So, now this chain is deliberately bought a little bit long, and I'm having quite a discussion with myself. If I put it on here so that this is the logical connection. Remember, you have to have two innies next to each other to put a master link through, okay? If I do this, I've got like 6 inches of play down here at the bottom. And that'll never be able to take it up. On the other hand, if I come up here to the next possible iteration and use it, it's really, really tight. Okay, so now I'm gonna try to get it up here. This one, I'm gonna keep this one flat. This one up here next to it, that's too loose, which means I have to go to this one here, which is like that. And nope, not even that, still got one more to go. And in order to do that, I really have to work hard. Now it's really tight, but really tight is going to loosen up. And I'm going to go ahead and shorten this one to here and use this as my master link. Okay, so now right now, I'm going to go ahead and mark it with some white paint so that I know which one to grind off. All right, now I can take it off, grind off this connector and put a master link through there. It's going to be tight, but it'll loosen up quickly. Go. All right, well, I use the grinding wheel to grind the ends off of the connector here. I'm going to use the chain breaker now to push them out. It doesn't take any real effort, but I'm going to go ahead and do it this way rather than trying to punch them out. And then I'll tell you a chain breaker story, which is kind of cool. There we go. Okay, now I can put the master link between these two pieces. Let me tell you an interesting story about a chain breaker. Going back a long time ago, my Norton was maybe 19. My Norton's a 74. I was going cross country with a buddy to go to Sturgis for the first time. And he's on his 750 Honda. I'm on my Norton. And we were traveling across country, and about halfway across country, we pulled into a campground, and we walked up to the office to get a campsite. And as we did, I saw five or six guys over on the other side of the parking lot kneeling down next to an older Harley, a chopper, and I could see one guy was filing furiously with a tiny little file about the size of a nail file. Thought about that. Anyway, we went in and got our campground and came out, and I was curious, so I walked over and said, "Hi guys, what's going on?" And they said they broke a primary chain on that particular Harley. It was a single row chain, and they broke it, and they were lucky. They got a ride down to a shop that worked on tractors who had chain, and they got a length of chain that would do just fine, thank you very much, except it was ever so slightly too long, and they were there trying to file it down, file off the connecting link to be able to put it on with that little bitty file. So I said to them, would you like a chain breaker? And they sort of looked at me like I was nuts and said, yeah. So I went over to the Norton and I took out the toolkit, and I reached in and I got out my little beaver chain breaker, which is a little square thing about that big, cubicle, and got a bolt on the side, and you put the chain in there and you screw it down, and it'll pop a chain apart. And I gave it to him, so there you go. And then I said, look, we're down the hill about six spots on the right when you get done. So Paul and I went down and started setting up our campsite. And I figured, you know, well, that's probably the last I'm ever going to see that little chain breaker. But what the heck, c'est la vie, it's helping out, doing a good job for somebody. Well, anyway, just a few minutes past that, I hear the rumble. Here it comes. And here come all five or six of them down that dirt path down to our campsite. And they pull up, and a guy gets off. He comes over and hands me my chain breaker and says, thank you very much. And then he takes out a six-pack of beer and he says, here, we got you a six-pack. And I said, well, gosh, thank you very much. And then they got on their bikes and they turned around, they rode out, and that was the end of the story. I thought that was kind of a cool story that A, I got my chain breaker back, B, I got myself a six-pack, and C, I was able to help out some guys on the road. Anyway, that's an interesting story about a chain breaker. So now I'm going to go ahead and put this chain on the bike, see if I can get the master link in, and we'll go from there. Okay, I'm going to do the final fit on the chain. I've got a couple of tools that I use to squeeze that last two links together. I've got this pair of pliers that over the years I've just modified and modified and modified and modified. They can be used to pull the last bit of chain together, like that. I also took a old link and have cut it down shorter and beveled the edges, and you can use this from the back or the front to pull those two ends together by forcing this down into the holes and it'll slide in. So we'll use one of these to make that final connection. Okay, now this is the moment of truth, whether or not I can stretch this chain all the way up there next to the other other end and get a master link into it. There they are next to each other. I'm going to see if I can get a master link in there straight away. And if not, then I'll start using some of the little tools. Okay, it's stretched really tight. Let's try these. There. Okay, I got it in. All right. Good. Now it's tight. It's right. I don't know if you can see that. It's tight, but it'll loosen up real quick. It's a brand new chain. All right. This is a nice Reynolds thin wall chain. Don't buy heavy duty chains. They're too wide. They rub on everything. Heavy-duty O-ring chains, especially for the older bikes. This is a 72. You might get away with it, but not a good idea. All right, so I'm going to put this on like so. See if I can get this on over. There's 42 ways of doing this easier And all I have to do is go over there and get a smaller screwdriver and everything will be fine. But I'm going to try to keep doing it this way. There. All right, last thing I'm going to show you. I'm going to stop this for a second. Okay. Yep, still on the microphone. I take a piece of safety wire and put it up through here, like so. It doesn't rub anything because it's in between the gap, okay? Bring it up here, put it over top. Tighten it down. I don't have safety wire pliers like I used to have in the Air Force, but you can do a pretty good job like this. You can also use a very thin piece of aluminum, just a strip down there, and then bend it over. Like so. And then cut it off. And then bend it down flat with the chain, like so. And it won't rub the inside of the chain guard. Like that. It's just a safety wire on the master link. Okay, well, we have ourselves a chain. Now I can put this chain guard back on and start putting the primary together. All right, gonna put the inner access plate in. You don't know the joy and the wonderment and the oh, it's just wonderful. When you put the whole clutch and drive assembly in, the alternator, you got everything wired up, and you look back on your bench and you see this plate laying there because you forgot to install it. It's just a wonderful feeling. So try not to forget it. I'm just going to put one screw in here, and then I'll just turn off the video while I get this guy started. There. Okay, I'll do the rest. Okay, I got the inspection plate. Access plate tightened down hand tight with screwdrivers as tight as it'll go. Now I'm going to use the impact tool. There. Just to give each one a love tap. Just a little bit more. Have to beat it up, and a heavy hammer like this 3-pounder is a whole lot better than a little hammer. Once again, we had this discussion not too long ago about mass and energy and impact and all kinds of neat things. I just know that hitting it lightly with a heavier hammer is better than beating the heck out of it with a lightweight hammer. All right. All right, it's 11:15 or so, and I'm going to call it a day because my lady friend wants to go to lunch, which, you know, so we're going to lunch. And after lunch, I have to go to Kevin's and be there at 1 o'clock. So we're gonna call it a day here. Got some good stuff done. Everything's organized. The new sprocket's in, the new chain is on. I will do the adjustment tomorrow, and everything's closed up, and it's as good a place to stop for the day as any. So we're going to call it the day. I'll do this video later on and post it.